don't panic. I mean, you know, volatility is extreme right now, and trying to trade, you know, this kind of volatility is probably not advisable for most of our clients on the retail side, for sure. On the institutional side, depending on the client, you know, opportunities are available every day. The volatility creates really good opportunities, so it depends on the client. But look, the bottom line here is that we have been in a bear market for several years. You know, we've said this before. We think that this is the finishing move to a two-year bear market. You know, we've made the call that basically bear markets end with a recession, right? So it doesn't mean that the lows are definitely in or that we're not going to chop around. It's going to remain volatile because we're in a bad economic event now with a lot of uncertainty. But we have to recognize, Brian, that, you know, markets have been trading very defensively for the better part of 2 years, and notwithstanding the fourth quarter rally, which was very much liquidity-induced and people were chasing around. I mean, you know, this is you know, kind of fits with that. Of course, the coronavirus combined with, you know, a oil price collapse, which has really infected the credit markets, has made this a recession that is somewhat unprecedented in terms of its speed and depth that we're seeing. But, of course, that's going to now invoke policy response that's also unprecedented. And we've already seen that from the Fed, which is incredible what they're doing in terms of the size and now acting in credit markets directly. And now we're waiting on this bill, of course, which, you know, is just a matter of size and timing, but we think it'll be fairly soon this week. So I think, you know, markets are properly, you know, have properly discounted the recession quickly. Mm-hmm. It's now trying to figure out, you know, are these good values? We think they are. We've been telling our clients for the last 2 weeks to start averaging in. And we think the lows are, you know, pretty much in for 90% of the stocks.
90% of this. I got a text from a hedge fund manager today basically suggesting that when the data begins to roll over in a positive way in Spain, we start to see Spain start to roll over. That gives us our path forward here, perhaps. And that's when the markets ultimately buy. Let's hope that is sooner than later. Would you agree with the basic thesis of that?
Well, I mean, that's part of it. I don't think you can point to any one metric. I mean, I could tell you that I thought when the credit market stabilized that that was the most important metric, okay? And that happened on Monday when the Fed injected themselves into the credit markets directly. So I think it's a series of things. I think it's the credit markets first. Funding and credit markets had to stabilize. That's happening. That's good. Volatility is coming down. That's good. The virus, you know, flattening out in Europe is obviously important, which people then believe it could happen here ultimately. And then I think it's just a matter of confidence, Brian. People have to get their confidence back because it's been shattered here, and that's what recessions do to people, both in terms of their behavior, in terms of what they're doing with their pocketbook, and what they're doing with their investment funds. So, you know, these always take a little bit of time. There'll be some testing, retesting, back-end filling, and we think, you know, this is a perfect time for real money, asset owner-type clients to put money to work over the course of the next month.
Is there any spot of the market right now you're advising just completely avoid at all costs still?
Well, I think that what you have to be careful about in these types of situations is there are going to be a lot of bankruptcies, right? There are going to be a lot of defaults. That's what happens in a recession. So we are telling clients, be a little bit careful with over-levered situations. You know, you don't need to be a hero here and try and buy the junkiest stuff out there. Although there is going to be a cyclical component to this recovery, you need to be, you know, vigilant about making sure that the balance sheets are good enough for the company to actually survive what is going to be a recession.